up, guys? I'm back here with another beginner guide. The last two on Kane did really well, so I'm gonna be doing that again here. For this video, it's gonna be a beginner guide on Kane, just regular Kane base form. I want to be more in depth with like his early game, showing you guys how you can abuse his actual early game with Z and finding gank patterns and stuff like that you can do. I know that he is really weak compared to other junglers, but he's also still able to have some really insane ganks, and he can fight certain champions depending on the circumstance. So I'm going to show you guys when and how. So here they're looking to invade us. Kane's level 1 Q is actually not as weak as people think. He can stack conquer super fast because his Q counts as 2 abilities. We do have the range advantage though, because we do have 5 melee champs. So this is a perfect game for Rost. And that's who I'm going to be going this game as well. Alright, so let me show you guys what I usually typically do when something like that happens early game. I always like to force an invade because I know they weren't able to ward here because they invaded us. So I'm able to take these raptors for free. And after these raptors, I'm going to look to E over the wall. Usually they don't expect you to do that, so you can, if you're quick with your smite and just spam the smite, it will be low enough for you to smite. Hopefully that's what happens here. Maybe the push. Ooh! Well, they failed their smite. Got him. Nice. So we can't really chase them because Velveth, but we can punish them. We can sit here a little bit and wait and see. Get them off the Krugs. Believe it or not, also the enemy bot lane is both Diamond 2 and Diamond 1, and the top laner is Diamond 2 as well. So it's a pretty decent Elo game. And what I typically do to deny them from being able to take my buffs when they're level 1, obviously, the only play Velveth has is to either she runs straight to my red and risk me coming to my red and contesting her, or she does her top side and then looks for my red because they would expect me to be on my bot side, clearing my blue and Gromp. But I'm going to counter that by, this is what I love doing. I love just going straight to my top side. All right, so let's go over the runes. The runes I chose to go this game were Conquer. And then for the secondaries, we went with the Resolve Tree. We went with Conditioning and Revitalize. I was thinking about going Unflinching because they have Rakan and they have the Fiora stun. But you can go either. I think both work fine here. All right, we know their bot lane has no sum, so I'm going to gank this here. Perfect. Snipe. I play really, really aggressive as Kane because I know my limitations. I know when I can and can't gank. I usually know how much damage I do as well. So at this point in the game, I'm super strong. So I usually look to contest. I only gank lanes though that I know that have potential for me to like kill. Like if they have no sums, or if I am dual with the laner or something like that, then I would obviously prioritize that. But yeah. Other than that, I do AFK farm a lot as well with Kane, but I think that in lower elos, you can really abuse the E and get a lot of stuff done early. All right, now let's go over the build that I'm going to be going this game. This game, I could have chosen to go the Manamune Gore Drinker build, but I feel like I'm going to need that early game pressure. So I did rush I'm rushing the Gore Drinker. So the build is going to be Gore Drinker, Death Dance, Cleaver into a Grudge. And then maybe a GA. I like going Grudge if I get ahead. So if I do get ahead, I am going to go Grudge. Maybe look for an invade, take the red buff, and then can work our way into the dragon. Okay, so we see them there. They more than likely don't see me though, so I can cheese this here. I'm really strong right now, so I know I can take this. The only thing I'm worried about is the Akali rotating on me. So the thing with Manamune, I do like going Manamune. I like going Manamune when I know that that the early game isn't gonna be, I'm not gonna be as needed in the early game, so I can go a little bit greedier build. But I think in this game I have to be at my strongest at all points, and I think getting that power spike Gore Drinker is what I'm gonna need to be able to carry this game. I am pretty ahead though, so I just have to maintain my lead by keeping my farm up, keeping my ganks up, getting my form. Just keeping the pressure up on the enemy jungle is what you want to be looking to do. I know a lot of players in lower elo waste a lot of time looking to gank, and they waste too much time like trying to get that gank to work. So try to save that extra seconds. Every second counts. You need to be doing something at all points in the game. Helping push wave, stuff like that. Like here, maybe I should help him push wave. Since I have Yumi with me now, I can make an aggressive play on top side, and yeah, we can make it work. usually with the only reason I'm gonna attempt the skank topside is only because I have the Yumi with me, so I can attempt it. But other than that, I would usually not attempt the gank top because the Renekton is a lot weaker. All right, so we do have the Yumi. We can maybe look for something here. Maybe a one-for-one trade, which would be worth on our favor because Renekton is losing, so we can take the pressure off him. Even if he dies, we can get Tower. So we could end up stunning him. Okay, so we got the flash. Renekton's not really worth any gold. Then we got the flash, so we can trade one-for-one here as well. The only reason I was just in case they make this for me, I don't wanna have them like kite me out and just heal up. Alright, we ended up getting their flash, we killed them. So I'm gonna look to do my Krugs here into red and then my topside cams into a reset and then maybe look for a play on dragon side. I'm super strong so I can look to force plays. Just you wanna be able to know when you can force and when you can't force play, because if you force a little bit too much, you'll end up dying and losing your lead, and then it'll make the game a lot harder. Alright, so matchups that you want to look to avoid for early game for Kane is the Graves, the Xin Zhao, and the Lee Sin. Those are three really, really strong early game matchups that you want to look to avoid and path opposite of, just to make sure that you don't lose your lead or like they counter gank you and then you end up dying. Early, if you die early to these matchups, they can snowball really hard on you and make the game super, super hard for you. So I would look to avoid them. Even I know that Kane players usually start red and do full clear. You have to kind of adapt your clear into those type of matchups. I know that is kind of annoying, but maybe starting bot side or blue side is a lot better because that way you can avoid them and not get snowballed on. So yeah, not every game you have to go cookie cutter build. I mean, cookie cutter path, you have to kind of adapt your path, and that's what makes a good Kane player from a bad Kane player. It's knowing when to do what with your pathing. Oh my god, look at all that healing, Jesus. All right, so, well, the video just turned into showing you how to carry 45 in Diamond Elo. So, yeah, it's like two things in one, so that's perfect. I'm not that tilted that he went AFK, he probably had some internet issues, so it's whatever. We're gonna try to do our best here, even if we do end up losing, which could happen because it is 45 and their comp is pretty strong. So you gotta stay positive, keep your mental strong. I know that it's tilting when you have an AFK, but as long as you keep your mental up, I think that and you use your fundamentals, I think you can win 45s with Yumi. Obviously, without Yumi, it'll be way harder. I don't think I would probably be able to carry this game without Yumi, but yeah. That's the only reason I ulted here is because I want to make sure that she doesn't have like great distance from me with her flash or anything like that. She's a priority target, so if I do end up killing her, they can't really do anything to me. So usually look to old priority targets. That's what we're gonna build into our cleaver because they have champions that have pretty decent armor, like Fiora's building death fans. Macaulay's probably gonna build hourglass, Rakan's gonna build some armor, and Velvet as well is gonna build armor. So I'm gonna look to counter that. Whenever I have a huge lead, I always take the camps. I always prioritize taking all their gold, especially from the enemy jungle, just to keep them as far behind as I can. Even in the 4v5, we've also been able to secure the dragons pretty well. This Kane Yumi combo is super strong. And I do get a lot of comments like telling me why am I playing like in Sarah Gold Evil. This actually is a diamond game. This is like D2 to like platinum game. So it's not really low elo. It's kind of above average elo. So maybe I'm showing you guys how to carry in this elo. I don't really like making videos in this elo. I just at the moment I'm leveling for my account just so I can do a grind to masters. Take the mid wave just in case. Maybe look to do something here. I do have a little bit more health now to play with. But I don't want to risk it. I don't want to end up giving them that shutdown. That's like the least thing you want to do. You don't want to. I am full health now and I am pretty strong. But like, going for those aggressive plays there would just lose me the game. If I die there, they just get Baron. They get so much more if I do end up dying there. So as long as I'm able to keep myself alive, that's all that really matters. Any like deaths at this point in the game would just throw the game super, super hard. One thing that you guys notice in these like gameplay videos, I'm always farming. Especially mid to late game, I'm always still keeping my farm up, keeping my levels up, never letting myself fall behind. Even though I have three deaths, two of them were really bad on my part, I'm still able to keep that kind of 10 CS per minute aspect of Kane. He's really, really good at farming, super efficient. I can chase him down here because if I'm able to get a pick off on them, I can pretty much work my way into Baron. Next, we got the Akali. I'm super strong. I thought that she was going to keep hold, but she didn't. Alright, she got their hold up, but I think she's still going to win this pretty hard because I'm super strong. Hey, Renek is still able to do something too. He's helping out. Nice. Usually, I know that we could get the inhib here easily, but the better play would have been that if our team fully runs with us here, they're not moving without pinging them. We should definitely run here to Baron and 100% secure the Baron, because the Baron is way better than the inhib mid. Because the reasoning is, mid inhib is decent if it's a little bit later into the game. But early game, they can easily push the mid wave and still rotate over to the Baron and the Dragon, two big key objectives. But if we get the Baron, we're able to secure so much pressure off the map, and then with the Baron, we can end up like 1-3-1-ing or 4-1. 1-3-1 is where you send one player top, three mid, and one bot, and we are able to push with Baron. Nice. I don't know where Rakan flashed in. I don't know if he thought he was going to steal this, but yeah, okay. Rakan is currently D2, so yeah. He's not actually low elo. I don't know why he thought he flashed in there. I don't know. The reason I make videos in low elo is not because I want to like show off or anything. It's just because the percentage of players are more so in that elo and playing in silver, gold, plat, diamond, and masters plus is three like different styles of games. Like games are a lot longer in the lower elos, and in the higher elos, the games are a lot shorter. A lot more is on the early game, so playing the early game perfectly in higher elos is really, really important compared to like the games dragging on in lower elos. All right, so we just pushed them off. We should have. The better play would have been for us to push mid and not really give the tower, because that makes puts a lot of pressure on us. But we do have the Baron recall, so even then pushing mid here isn't really the right play. Because we could either just recall and collapse them then, or we can just literally flank them like we are now. Then we're going to look to flank them here. We're way stronger, so them pushing this is super troll. That's for the group. We just one shot Kali. Hey, we're necking Duskio, huh? Nah, but he's doing pretty good compared for like a guy who DC'd for a while. He's doing okay. So most people would just tilt in that scenario, right? The Renekton AFK, he looks kind of doomed. Like a lot of people would rage in those moments. And yes, when I started the game, I would rage in that scenario too. I would probably lose myself. I would lose the game solo just from like anger that he AFK'd. But it's really important to keep that cool head and try to find like places you can punish the team, enemy team, because not everyone's gonna play perfectly. So there's always a way to get ahead. And one more thing that I want to go over on early game Kane, his E is super, super effective. Like, especially in their lower elos, there's so many angles you can look to go for. Like, I'm super experienced with Kane, so I look to do three cams. I usually do red, Krugs, Raptors, and then I usually gank bot. And I go through this dragon pit here. It's really, really, really effective. Like, they won't really expect it. But it's only if you're really experienced with ganking, you have to make sure you're landing the W and kind of seeing if there's like an angle. If they're pushed a little bit further past the midway point of the bot lane, that's when you can look to go for that gank. I think that the full clear obviously is going to be more efficient in the long run, like in most elos. So I'm not saying to move away from the full clear, but you can look for angles in certain games. Some games you have to look to gank early game to kind of stop a lane from snowballing or help your lane snowball. So now at this point in the game, since I'm this strong and I do have the human, I am going to look to force just so we can end up closing the game up, because the longer it goes, the more they outscale us. Well, they outscale our Renekton, not really like me and Jinx. I think that Jinx scales super well. That's what's really good. You mean we got the double root. But we get the pick off on them. We can easily kill Fiora here. Slow is super insane too. It's really, really annoying. I love this item. Like, I love Grudge. I think it's super fun. I think it should only be built if you're really ahead though, because it does make you squishier than normal. So we can just look for the end here, because we do see the Akali top side. Alright, so we can end the game here. I'm super strong. If they end up fighting us, I can just end up one-shotting them. So I'm going to ignore them here and just hit the tower. Or should I get the tower first before I ult? I think I could have used my ult a little better there. It's whatever though. I'm just so strong, it doesn't really matter. I just literally one-shot them with Grudge. Oh man, I thought she would like use her E. I thought she would have kited up, actually. Okay. Jesus Christ, what Q does devastating damage. But yeah, guys, if you guys like the video and you want to see me do more Kane content, let me know what type of video you guys want to see me do. If you guys want me to do like matchups or a higher elo game when I rank up my account. Yeah, so if you like the video, leave a like and a comment. Let me know what you guys thought of the video. And thank you guys so much for watching.